If you could spend a moment with some remarkable people and discover what their life sounds like, what would you ask? Welcome to Are We On Air, an audio encounter. I'm Armand Lafay, and each episode will feature one conversation with an inspiring friend of mine who will share with us the soundtrack to their life. Welcome back to another episode of Are We On Air? I am your show's host, Armand Lafay, and this week we are being joined by the wonderful Sarah Andelman, the creative genius behind the now defunct and legendary concept store in Paris, Colette. We of course talked about the history and the concept behind it. There are now infamous music compilations, which had a huge influence on my life, and the upcoming documentary. But we also talked about her life after Colette, with her latest venture, Just an Idea. And if retail, in particular a concept store, would still work in today's world. As always, do leave us a lovely review on the Apple Podcasts app and spread the love. I'll speak to you soon. So welcome back to another episode of Are We On Air? I have the honor to be here in Paris with the beautiful and wonderful Sarah Andelman in her beautiful studio on Rue Saint-Honoré. Welcome, Sarah.
Thank you.
It's great to be in your studio, in your universe, and I'm looking around all these beautiful artifacts from 20 years of Colette. And I was just, while I'm walking up to your studio, I was like, is it strange to see your old store every day with now Saint Laurent inside? It must be kind of a funny, weird feeling, no?
It's funny, I don't even realize because I also live very close from here. So it has always been my neighborhood, my little corner. Now, weird is not anymore the name. It just, you know, you get used to it.
Yeah, for a lot of people, including myself, it's weird to come to Paris and not do your obligatory stop at Colette anymore, you know? Like, we used to come and the first stop was always Colette and then see what's new, and especially music and the compilations and the latest releases. So, yeah. And as you know, I also interviewed some of our peers and friends for this series, including Michel Goubert, who used to do the records, the compilations for you, and André Saeva and Loudoyon, and yeah, so forth. So it's nice to be here. Thanks for having me. So to begin with, what's your earliest significant musical memory that shaped you as an artist?
Alors, I don't know if it shaped me, but I still have them. My first records I booked when I was maybe 8 years old, and I think it already shows a different tests extreme. It's a Rapper's Delight by Sugar Hill Gang. I said a hip hop, the hip it, the hip it, the hip hip hop. You don't stop the rocket to the bang bang boogie. Say up jump the boogie to the rhythm of the boogie to beat. Now what you hear is not a test. I'm rapping to the beat, and me, the groove, and my friends are gonna try to move your feet. You see, I am Wonder Mike, and I like to say hello. Up to the black, to the white, the red, and the brown. And apparently doesn't nobody knows about them, the Star Sisters, Sarson 45. He was a famous trumpet man from old Chicago. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was a chop man at his craft, but then his number came up and he was going with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing rivalry. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy, company B. I remember these are the first 45 tours. Do you say like this? A record I booked and I played all the time before to discover all those other kind of music.
When was it? Do you remember?
I was 8 years old because it says 1983 on the record. So I couldn't tell exactly, but I looked at them last night for you. Took a picture if you don't believe me, and it says 1983.
I believe you. Well, how would you describe yourself with three songs?
Alors, it's a not easy question, but I thought of some of favorite ever songs. There is a Groove is in the Heart from Delight, so maybe a little groovy. There is a Snob, Je suis Snob by Boris Vian, and Rêve for the Dreaming Side, Imagine, classic by John Lennon.
Imagine all.
Do you have any particular moments that you cherish with these songs?
No, when I hear the Delight song, I think we cannot not dance a little.
The chills that you spill up my back keep me filled with satisfaction when we're done. Satisfaction of what's to come. No walls, only the bridge. My supper dish, my cockatash wish.
Sing it, baby.
I couldn't ask for another. No, I couldn't ask for another.
And I loved all the Boris Vian music in general, and novels, and his life.
Je suis snob. C'est vraiment le seul défaut que je gobe. Ça demande des mois de turbin. C'est une vie de galérien. Mais quand je sors avec Hildegarde, c'est toujours moi qu'on regarde. Je suis snob, foutrement snob.
What was the question already? How did it react to a moment, special moments? Not really. I pick them all. I always listen to them with pleasure. I feel I will never get tired of them. It's kind of timeless.
It's a video of some tracks that can be timeless.
Yeah.
Well, talking about timeless music, I'm surrounded by beautiful compilations of Colette right here, and I hope you stack them just for me in front of you. I mean, obviously, Colette was a one of the taste-making spots for the past 20 years, especially when it came to music. And for me, I would just come and just see what you guys were up to. And I know it's very hard because you have so many beautiful compilations and so much music that came through. But do you have a song that would define or represent Colette for you?
Clearly, it's not an easy question, but give one song, it's music has always been important for Colette. Of course, we had Gilda from Kitsune who helped for the selection at the very beginning, and when we started to do the compilation with Michel Gobert, of course, it was a fantastic adventure. And I think when you listen, look at them now, it's really reflect the time, the moment. And now one song, I don't know why I picked a LCD sound system. Daft Punk is playing at my house.
That was on the third floor?
Yes. I'm not sure exactly. We could check, but...
it's the fourth probably.
Daft Punk is playing at my house. I'll show you the ropes, kid. Show you the ropes. Got a bus and a trailer at my house. I'll show you the ropes, kid. Show you the ropes.
I remember because I obviously got them back in the day, and I agree these are great snapshots, and that's the beauty of like a product, a tangible product you can hold, that it's not just streaming music, where it's a snapshot of the zeitgeist of that period. I think that's the beauty of, in comparison just to online music, you know, it's something that stays with you. And now you can look at it.
Here it's all wrapped. Because what was great is, of course, the curation from Michel, but also working with Ezra Petroniou for the design, plus... For that's for the Colette series, and we did some little extra guests with different partners. And also, it was the way we would do events around them. Of course, when we did the culture club in Gant with too many DJs, with James Murphy from LCD in Tokyo, maybe in Gant as well, or Vive la Fête. It was all these incredible moments, which were the extension from the CD, the object, which was really a great adventure.
Did you have live performances in the store itself?
Of course, we had a lot. Well, it was not really, it was a shop, even if we had a gallery, it was not. But yes, we did some event at one point, I remember, for Fête de la Musique with Tidal. We completely emptied the second floor to do live performance. And we had Clément Vacher, now he's doing music work, who also organized some music live moments in the water bar once a month. And there is lots of young artists who became really big a few months after. So I'm happy it was the goal for Colette to introduce new talents and who would become even more famous after.
Yeah. Okay, you popped up on me by surprise.
Yeah, yeah.
You see, I never took you for the positive type. Give it for my ears, so please believe the hype.
Okay, okay.
Hit the lights. Yeah, yeah. I'm on your baton, let's go. Pop me thinking, jump a piss in the location. I'ma put up in that bulletproof spaceship. Drop off a bag of disappointments.
I mean, that's a talent and a skill to have in the first place, that you obviously have. I know it's hard to pick as well, but do you have a favorite compilation?
Oh yes, no, that's impossible because they all count. Of course, I'm tempted to say the last one is very special to my heart. It's Colette 20, picked with a selection by Pedro Winter. He picked one song by year, so it's from 1997 to 2017. And in the middle of the track, there is some little message from Monsieur Lagerfeld, Johnny Hallyday, Pharrell, my son. So it's really, really a special one. So.
Oh, wow. Can't wait to hear it.
This is Santi Gold, and I'm just here to tell you that Colette, c'est chouette.
Colette, c'est chouette. Colette, c'est chouette.
Colette, c'est chouette.
Colette, c'est chouette.
Well, we live in a post-pandemic, or we're in the midst of a pandemic still, unfortunately. But I think even before that, the idea of a brick-and-mortar store, especially a concept store, was already struggling with the new world, the online world. How would you open a new Colette today?
No, personally, no. but it doesn't mean that it should not exist other great multi-brand stores, because anything made, I think, with authenticity, we still need platform. I'm a pro online, directed consumer from brand. It's a great easy experience, but it's true. It's always nice also to come in a space, to listen great music, and to be in the in the mood to discover new things, to not necessary products. It can be artworks. It can be anything.
Experience.
Exactly.
I mean, I think that's the fine line to go today, because it's because of the internet, all the genres, all the borders are blurred. They're like one. So what you can sell or you can give that online can't do is create an atmosphere that's an experience, a warm atmosphere. You can come and just be in and then explore, of course, products or services. Well, how was it when you started 97 here?
Oh, 97, it was a prehistoire from now. It was this neighborhood was not at all what it is now. It was in between the luxury from Faubourg Saint-Honoré and more street Les Halles. And it all came from this building, this location, and the wish to bring together this world. And I think there was appetite for something new in Paris, because there was a lot of things happening in London, in New York, but Paris was a little going down. And it was not easy to introduce a new concept, style, design, art, food, and lots of people thought it won't last for more than 6 months, but with love and work, we managed to continue. It was always very natural for us. We never did a marketing plan, we should do that or this. We just did what we wanted to do with lots of freedom. Was it your question, or not at all?
Fantastic. I love it. But I think also Paris at that time, speaking musically with the French Touch movement, and there was a lot of coming out of France already. So I think culturally, there was a movement happening that is not, obviously, there was not in competition with London or Berlin, but it had its own flavor. I think that's what kind of made it happen as well.
No, totally. Of course, it's not only Colette. There is always a synergy of different things happening. And of course, the French Touch, it was fantastic to we didn't know each other at the time back in 97, but very soon enough, we start to work with Air. I remember we did a little exhibition for Moon Safari with Mike Mills, with, I don't know, Phoenix, and all these artists. And it was definitely something happening. The club, the scene was important, too. Yeah.
Well, I hope I can still catch one of these cities redeveloping, refining themselves. Well, we are also in your studio, which is also acting as your new agency, your new business venture, which is Just an Idea. Tell us about Just an Idea, and if you could choose a song, what to represent it?
It's a continuity from Colette. I help brands to develop collaborations with another brand or an artist. It's a lot of connecting dots together, and it's curating for special projects, so it's very open, and I am happy to work a little in fashion, beauty, design, high tech. So it's for me, it's a progression phase two from Colette. And one song, didn't think about this one, but I would say happy from Pharrell, even if that's very, but I'm very happy with this new phase, and it's great to see project help to make some projects happening. Yeah.
Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel.
Now that you're in that new phase, your new happy phase as well, do you sometimes get tired to talk about Colette or be associated so much with Colette? Or is that, obviously it opens a lot of doors in a way, but also you're like, oh, I'm trying to do something new here.
That's fine. That's part of me. It was really my life nonstop for 20 years, so I cannot deny it. And I'm relaxed about yes, I was. It's fine. Of course, now I also want to prove I'm doing new things in a different way. And it's also interesting for me to be behind the scene and to give, you know, more space and to be more, if I need to do a project in different cities. And yes, I don't think Colette will always be part of me, I think.
Not a bad part to be. Well, what have you recently discovered in music, art or film that got your attention?
Alors, it's not very new, but in music during this summer and even before, but we listen a lot of Khruangbin, and it's always no mistake. It's, we love it. Art, I thought of Sho Shibuya, this art director based in New York who started during the lockdown to paint this dégradé on the cover of the New York Times. And I plan to work with, I'm working with him on a project. And on movies, we watch on Criterion this Olympics movies. There was one in Japan Olympics from 64, I think, which is absolutely fascinating. It's 3 hours, there is no comment, and it's just incredible, the cinematography on it. But I also just saw The Phantom Toolbooth by Chuck Jones. It's a kid's movie, but it's also, I loved it.
I can't wait to dig deep into this. Well, to go slightly more intimate, what's your go-to falling in love or heartbreak song?
I think of Les Histoires d'Art by Rita Mitsouko. I listened a lot of the Rita Mitsouko, and I think this song helped me, if I had a rupture, to get over it. I also think of Parole.
Ah, love Parole.
I think Parole and Histoire d'Art are the same. It's what it is about, a love story sometimes. Just une parole. Parole, parole, parole. Écoute-moi. Parole, parole, parole. Je t'en prie. Parole, parole, parole. Je te jure.
Well, what's the sexiest song?
Alors, this is sort of Something About Us from Daft Punk. I don't think it's one of their most well-known, but I love, love, love this song.
It might not be the right one. It might not be the right time. But there's something about us I've got into. Some kind of secret I will share with you. I need you more than anything in my life. I want you more than anything in my life. I'll miss you more than anyone in my life. I love you more than anyone.
It's a very, very sexy song. Well, to wrap up our little chat, if your life would be a movie, what song would play in the end credits?
Alors, actually, not only me, but we had this documentary, Colette, Mon Amour, on the last 6 months of Colette, which will come out soon on the streamline. And the music from the generic is really, is really one of my favorite ever, and is L'Arrêt Tournelle de Sébastien Tellier.
Beautiful, and what a great way to end the movie. I can't wait to see the film. It's not out yet, right?
You will be able, December 20.
I'll be counting the days. Thank you, Sarah. It's been a
pleasure. Thank you very much. Oh, this is not changing up for you. I want to spend my life with you. So we make love on the grass and under the moon. No one can tell.
This episode's playlist, visit areweonair.com, where you'll be able to enjoy the full playlist mentioned in this conversation.